All right. Way to chew us in, Stefan. Do you like the sound of a man chewing his own cud?
This is ASMR now.
I think there's actually a tag on Twitch for ASMR. I really do. I'm probably going to have a fucking audio spike.
Is this soothing?
Should I even bring up the sound bites? We don't do sound bites anymore.
Is this soothing to your human ears?
It seems like ASMR has fallen off the front.
I'm not surprised.
Yeah.
I mean, that's definitely a flavor of the week type
for
deal.
Real, how long can you do just fucking, I'm going to whisper into the mic. Now it's like,
are you?
The latest ASMR stuff I've seen is more of like a parody of ASMR, and it's been like cat ASMR. Welcome, enter Bane. It's been like high compression microphone setup of kittens just like licking water, just like.
Yeah, but that's because I said that. Like I said, that one dude with the sound putty, and he was just making fat noises into it. Like, that's hilarious.
Right.
Other than the commitment to the joke, because you're probably doing like a 6-hour stream or something of just you making fap noises. Mm. That's commitment. I respect that.
Yeah.
I respect that brand of humor.
Shit, I forgot to change it to the other channel. So,
Marcus, if you're out there, I got the chat box open this time.
Yeah.
Sorry, so, there, fella.
Let me just get up. Sorry, there. Bud. Why don't you just keep it rolling there while I switch over the.
Are you going to switch over? I was going to spit out my gum because I forgot, you know. Yeah, I kind of had a busy week. And
how busy was it, Stefan?
Dude, I refurnished my entire bedroom.
Nice.
So the new bed.
The haunted headboard?
Oh, that's been gone, though. Right. I got a new bed frame for starters and like two wardrobes.
Is this you?
No, that's not me.
That's the other one? Is that not
that's Belize. It's not even me.
Okay, so how many bed sets have you been through in this home of yours?
This is the second one. This is the second one, actually. Because that other frame never showed up, so this is the second bed set I've ever had, actually, in my life.
Yeah. Oh, cool. There you go.
I still got dressers from when I was living with my dad a decade ago.
I still haven't put together a bed set that my parents got for me. It's just in boxes in there.
Woo!
You know,
that's great.
One time my mom called me up. God bless her soul. She calls me up on a Sunday and she's like, "We want to take you to Steinhoffel's because there's a sale going on. We'll get you a couch." And I was like, "Mom, I live in a condos. I live in an apartment style condo. I can't just like get a couch without planning it out. I have to like get rid of something." So I appreciate the gesture, but I just don't have the space for it.
But how'd you get this bad boy?
That one?
Is this the Steinhoffel's bad boy? It's
that one was
reclining.
That one was still intact. This is like before. Oh my god, that fucking thing. That thing failed on me so hard. When I needed it the most, because I was sleeping in it, like in the reclining part of it, where you're sitting right now, actually.
And it failed.
The reason it's up against that wall is because if it's not, the entire back end of that will just fall to the
topple
ground.
Topple out.
Yep. And I was.
Thanks for the heads up.
I was sleeping in that thing when I had to keep my leg elevated.
And it failed.
Yeah. Like, I just remember one night. I had my like a beanbag under my leg to keep it elevated, and I was like sleeping like fully reclined, and then the fucking chair in the middle of the night while I'm sleeping just like falls backwards, and I'm just like in it, and I'm just like,
oh,
and I'm like, fuck it, and I just go back to sleep, and I wake up in the morning like, what the fuck happened?
Did you ever find out? Like, did a spring break?
It just broke. Well, I couldn't. Spring break. That's over with, Stefan. You're a little late for that one. I don't know. I think it's just old, and it's been through. It's seen a lot of abuse. It's seen a lot of wild animals, which I call friends, come through and just tear it to pieces.
Yeah, where the wild things are.
I turned into that guy where it was like people would sit on the arm just because we'd be like hanging around the fringe of the living room and someone would sit down on there and be like, hey, don't sit on that arm. It'll break the couch. I've become my father.
I think we all become
slightly more attached. After you go through two couches.
Yeah, I think we all come I think we all become slightly more attached to the things we purchase.
But the thing is, did not purchase that. That was a great couch, though. I mean, look at the fucking leather. It's still in great shape. I mean, it's a little bonded. Scratched up, but look at this. Look at this here.
That's bonded for sure. Yeah.
This shit I've had for a few months, and the cats have just...
What is this, lambs?
Destroyed lamb it. I don't know. It's like
sheep leather or whatever. That
pure cruelty.
That's what we like.
All right, so back
cruel
to the,
and unusual.
Back
punishments.
To the bedroom decor. Does it look? Did you take the skateboards down?
We haven't gotten quite there yet. We took us.
Whoa! We haven't got quite there yet.
I don't have the wardrobe set up either. They're still boxed up. The frame and headboard itself was our Tuesday. Because we bought them Saturday. Then we had to split off after we bought them. She had to go to work. I had to go.
It's still like 8 feet in the 8 feet in the air.
What?
Bed frame. It's like super high.
Oh, this bed frame's higher than the other one, but it's great.
Jesus.
It's got storage underneath it. So I it's suppose. Got pull-out drawers, which are great. Literally fit everything in my dresser in the pull-out drawer on my side. The two of them.
Pull out. Ding.
Yeah. And it's got storage in the headboard. It's actually really nice. Nice dark.
Do you know what's the best?
Dark black, and we got a new rug in there.
No bugs that got sealed in, just scraping away.
No curse of the mummy. no feral curse.
No curse of Tom Cruise.
Yeah.
Fucking.
Did I tell you my downstairs neighbor fell?
The deaf guy?
Oh, he's not deaf, but I tell you that he fell.
Hard of hearing guy? No, you didn't tell me that he fell.
Oh.
Like Rome?
I didn't share this story last week.
No.
That my downstairs neighbor fell down?
You weren't here last week.
I don't remember when this happened. Okay, if I didn't share it on here, I'm going to share it, though. So, okay.
Share away.
We came home like one of these past Saturdays. Time is just flying by. I'm sorry. But we came back one of these Saturdays, and B said, oh, our downstairs neighbor hasn't picked up his newspaper. And there's like three or four newspapers down here. I think he may be in trouble. And it's like, oh, he probably just went out of town or something, or... Because he has a regular caretaker that comes and checks on him. Brittany said, well, I'm going to call our landlord tomorrow. I was like, all right. She calls our landlord when she's at work so that I have to then when I get home do the double check. Very sneaky. But my landlord said, yeah, we tried calling. He's not picking up. Can you hear his phone when we call? So I go up to his door. They call, I hear the phone ring. I'm just like, oh, great. My downstairs neighbor is just dead in there.
Oh, no.
Because he's an older fellow. Yeah. But it turns out he'd fallen, and he'd just been laying on the ground for like 3 days.
Whoa, dude.
So me and Britt then, now that this new information had come to light, are just like, oh, my God. Now that I think back on it, like we were reminiscing the past week, it's just like, holy shit. Like, I think he was actually calling for help, and I thought it was his TV or something. Just like, I'm a terrible person.
As we, I'm a terrible person.
But, jeez, man.
That's rough. Remember I don't want to bring that up. The time that we found.
Oh, the crazy lady over there that I helped? Yeah.
She, like, literally could not get over the
doors
from tile to carpet.
Yeah, and her electric scooter.
It wasn't electric. It was, like, a walker.
Whatever was going on. She should not have been living by herself.
No, that was like weird. We found her, like her door was like cracked open.
I said, help.
Yep.
Help.
Like, I had like left for work and you guys had gone in already. And I went in after. And then we had to like we got her to her bed and we were like, what do we do?
It's like, bye. Son's
do
a
we
doctor.
Call?
She kept saying that. She's like, my son's a doctor.
I remember she's like, well, are you angels? Stefan's just holding her hand. What a nice young man you were.
I mean, it was literally like holding a skeleton's hand.
Yeah.
But we found emergency numbers on the fridge.
We were just like, what do we do? Do we call the ambulance? Do we call a hospital? And thankfully, we found like the information. There was like a packet that was like, if you find me, I have dementia and
and I live alone. Call the neighbor. Some reason. Yeah.
And it, like, thankfully, the next door neighbor was the person that was designated to take care of her.
But still, that's just all.
So we had to go wake up another very old man.
I feel like he was awake, though. He was just like, I'm putting pants on or something. I remember him, like, already being awake. And I was like, oh, thank God you're an old person.
Fucking awkward. I had to call into work and be like, yeah, we found one of our neighbors is just, like,
being senile.
Yeah.
And, yeah, you go in your apartment. It's up to, like, 89 or 98 degrees.
I think she was one of the first of my neighbors to go. I think I've had, like, 4 or 5 neighbors die in the time that I've been here.
But when you moved in here, this was pretty full of just older folks.
It's the strangest thing. It was like touted as being like old people only kind of place, but you know, all
you got
of them
some
are,
real winners in here now.
Really? What do you mean by that?
Like a couple weeks ago, I pulled up and there were some very interesting characters coming in. I was just like, oh. Y'all look up like you're up to no good.
Well, the thing about it is when you have a community like that, you have to like keep the money coming in, and then people start to die. So you got to get new blood in.
Let's just say one of the people that I saw coming in here straight up looked like a movie hooker. Like ripped fishnets, like hair just blazoned all over. I don't know if you're mocking me or the movie hooker.
$5 for you, 60 for your friend.
Yeah, her hair just exploded everywhere, like ripped fishnets, like wobbly walking, and just a greasy looking fellow just like, oh yeah, walking her in here.
Let me see here.
Should pull up some security footage if we can.
We got
Friday 3 weeks ago.
We got feedback coming from somewhere. Where is it?
Better locate that.
All of our 8 listeners,
our friends and family.
All right, I'll figure that out fucking some other time. So
where are you Ubering to when I texted you and you're just like, that's funny?
When was this?
Like 2 weekends ago. I texted you about that pickup hockey game I had.
Oh, yeah.
I can tell that story, too.
I was going to hang out with brother Corey.
Oh, wait, in Chicago? I thought he was in Chicago.
No, he was in town for that weekend. That was the 420 weekend, wasn't it?
Was it?
Yep, pretty sure. And, fucking
yeah,
hell.
I think that would be correct.
You went up, I just punched our listeners in the mouth.
Get some.
You want to pull the audio jack out of there for a second? That is not it. Go ahead and plug it back in. That is going to drive me fucking crazy.
If it's driving you crazy, leave a comment in our Twitch chat box. We're monitoring it.
So, I went to hang. He like got me out of the house. I wasn't really planning on doing anything for that, but I immediately regretted like going out because
I wasn't there.
I ended up smoking some pot.
Ooh.
And I hadn't. Yeah, I really shouldn't have.
Free Liberation Radio.
Wake up, well, radio. But the thing is, when you smoke pot with your pothead friends who smoke a lot of pot, you end up not having a great time because you have a introspective nightmare and you start fucking creating these situations that do not exist in your own head. And you just be like, man, I know I'm just like freaking out right now, but
I'm like freaking out, man.
It's fucking for real, man. Like I truly do understand the plight of the paranoia.
The scaries.
I just really don't have...
I get the scaries when I smoke.
I don't have fun smoking pot. I turn into a nervous fucking wreck and don't have fun. Some people get giggly.
And Doug just wants to tear his own face off.
Yeah. I Ubered back within maybe like 2.5 hours. I was like, I just need to go home.
You get in the Uber.
I need my inhaler.
You get in the Uber. The guy turns around with like a phantasm type.
He's like the fucking the cab driver in Home Alone 2. He's like, it ain't in any better in here, kid.
You're just hyperventilating the whole ride home, fumbling fucking, for your keys to get inside.
Fucking Ed Bighead picks me up in an Uber. Rocco! What are you doing out at your friends of smoking pots?
Oh, Rocco, don't worry about Ed. He's just angry. He doesn't have any friends.
Oh, God.
Okay.
What the fuck is the name of the guy from Independence Day who's Jeff Goldblum's boss? And he's just like,
oh, David, I gotta call my mother. I gotta call my lawyer.
I don't have that.
Actually, forget him.
I forget his name. It's like he's very gay. Very New York. But he sounds exactly like Bev Bighead. It sounds like he gargles sand and chunks of glass before he talks ever.
I gotta call my lawyer, this guy?
Yeah, yeah.
Oh my God. Oh my God. Oh my God, I gotta call my brother. I better call my housekeeper. I gotta call my lawyer. Forget my lawyer.
Yeah, it's that dude. Doesn't that sound like Bev Bighead? Kinda.
Yeah. I can't recall that actor's name though. He used to just be like that
tip
I smoke.
Of my tongue.
He's just that I smoke packs a day Long Islander voice. Yeah.
On top of being very, very gay.
Flamboyant. Yeah.
Well, he's pretty out in the open, so
yeah.
It's okay to say. Very gay.
So what was Corey doing out here?
He's just like hanging out with some friends.
He's up to the same.
One of the guys that we had over the last time he came over, who also has a podcast. So I was like, "How's your podcast doing?" He's like, "It's on hold."
Oh, taller, skinny buddy.
Yeah, I like that dude. He's cool to hang out with. Dude, we were just having a fucking blast in the Uber on our way to his next friend's house, and we were having so much fun that the person in the front seat, his friend who had ordered the Uber, was like, "Guys, behave! I don't want to get a bad rating." So.
What did you say? What is this, China?
Yeah. It's like, I thought this was America. I thought this was the United States of America, okay?
Yeah.
Like, I didn't feel like we were really being that obnoxious, but we were kind of on a different level of fun that person was. It was like me.
On a different level.
It was like me on the night we went and saw The Force Awakens and you.
Yeah, on a different level. I mean, you were puking on the night of Force Awakens.
Yeah, but to make that sound better, I was not drunk puking.
No,
I was deathly sick puking.
I don't know what happened there. You were like fine, and then as soon as we started driving, you were like, I don't feel so good.
I had already been puking. Steve-O had an interesting night that we will not go into the details of. And he wakes up super late because we had all planned to go to this movie.
Yeah.
So we have to go across town in rush hour to the airport from the west side to get him and then go back. And as soon as I got him, I was just like driving my Jetta with, it was like you, me, Jake, and him. And I was like, man, I don't feel too good. Like, I already knew that, like, things were coming down. And then we got back here, started puking. And before we left, I was like, Jake, I don't think I can drive. Yeah. I don't think I could drive. Can you?
Jake was driving.
And we put him in the hot seat of driving a manual transmission car that he wasn't used to.
He did great.
Yeah, he did pretty good. So we stop at the gas station to get some, or we stop at Walgreens to get some Pepto. I down some Pepto. I need some gas. We go maybe a couple blocks up on our way to the Majestic up Capitol. Dox me. And
start puking again.
Yeah, I didn't puke at Walgreens, but I remember this vividly. I remember this like it was fucking seen in a movie I could watch over and over again in my mind. I fucking had a double Woodman's bag, you know, in case there was a little hole in one.
No leakage, please.
I just remember it fucking, we pull up to the gas station, I fucking open the door, turn and put my feet out of the door and immediately start vomiting profusely.
I remember that too.
I was just like just while you're going, oh,
meanwhile, like, I'm just like, are we gonna make it, guys?
Stefan comes up to behind me and he puts his hand on my shoulder. He's like, are you okay there? But I'm just like, get the fuck away from me. I had already fucking like had it at that point.
It was
with
over.
Him. Because Stefan was, he had the day off. He had the next day off. And he decided, I'm going to go see Star Wars and we're going to have
a good
time.
I think I had a bunch of little shooter bottles.
Yeah, you
too.
Had a bunch of, you
I had
were
travel
liquored
bottles.
Up.
Yeah. I had travel bottles and shit because I think we had just got back from, had I just got back from DC or something? I remember for some reason I had a bunch of little travel whiskey bottles. And I was just like, yeah. You're going to Force Awakens. It's going to be great. Star Wars is awesome. And then Star Wars is okay.
So I'm like pregnant. I'm like pregnant ladying it the rest of the way to the fucking theater. I'm just like, and
I went to the Majestic too, and there was a big ass fucking line.
Yep.
But we skipped past all that.
We skipped past that because I already had tickets from Fandango.
Please sponsor us.
Yes. If you ever want to buy tickets in advance and then not have them be redeemable when you get to the theater.
You go Fandango.
Fandango! I've actually never had that problem, but... so we get there.
There's
it's,
a dude
it's
in
almost
front.
Showtime.
Yeah, there's a dude in front of the theater who was just crying Han Solo dies at the end.
He didn't,
there, no, he wasn't. Like, there was a news team there, though.
Yeah, that was actually on the way out.
Yeah, because we were talking about doing that and being spoilers.
So we go in.
Well, Steve-O wasn't.
That's like later on in this story. Yeah. We go in, and Stefan's just like,
I haven't eaten
hungry.
All day.
I haven't eaten all
but
day.
But I said that before we had even left. And I said, you guys go ahead, and I'll meet up with you.
I was like, Stefan, there's no way we're going to find four seats together. Because it was like back, it was back when it was the like a lawless Wild West.
Yeah,
you buy
said,
your tickets,
you
and
guys
sit
just
together.
Go ahead, and then I'll.
So we ended up having Britt to sit in too? The fucking front row. No, that was a different Star
yeah,
Wars.
Yeah, that was the second one. Britt didn't make that one.
So Stefan, I'm just like, God damn it, Stefan. So we go and get our seats, and then Stefan gets a pizza.
And everyone was loving it, but you.
No. Not really. I was just
what
like
talking about Jake had like three pieces.
Okay. Just let me say this. Fucking Stefan gets Stefan's drunk ass walks into the theater and then sits down and I'm like two seats away from him. Someone's sitting between me and Stefan.
Jake
opens the pizza box and as soon as the fucking smell of the vomit cheese that they finish this thing with hits my nostrils. I'm just like, oh my God. I like literally stand up right then and there and run to the bathroom and continue to puke my guts out.
Yeah. Dougie was sick.
And then I fucking come back. We start the first act of the movie. And there's a certain point in time. I think it was in between whenever they fucking are running through the junkyard and they find the Millennium Falcon in the junkyard. I missed that because I had to get up again.
To vomit.
I made the mistake in my haste to not puke on the floor. I actually ran into the woman's bathroom.
Oh, well.
I know.
No one was in there, right?
You just, at was the just time, like a, it was just like, I just like go into a stall, start puking, and then somebody sits down in the stall next to me, and I notice that's lady shoes.
Those is high heels. Guys don't wear high heels.
So I'm just like, oh, fuck. So I literally, like, cancel my vomiting and then walk out, and there's a lady coming, and I'm like, sorry, sorry, I'm really sick. And I was just, like, thinking in my head, I was like, yeah, you are, you fucking pervert.
I don't remember. You never told me that part.
So then I cross the hall back to the men's bathroom and then proceed to finish my blood puke. And that's when I called Amanda. I actually started texting her. I was like, I'm super sick at Star Wars, and I'm starting to miss the movie. I don't know how long this is going to go on. You think you could pick me up? She's like, oh, me and my friend are hanging out. We were drinking wine. I was like, oh, man.
I was
oh, maybe literally I do about that. To fucking
I think
just,
I remember
like,
you telling
up.
Us that you texted Amanda or something. But, yeah, we were... Steve and Jake and I were eating pizza. I think it was Zaffiro's. Cause, or do they have a full-service Zaffiro's at the Majestic?
I don't know. I haven't been there in a while.
Yeah.
So, speaking of premiere movie experiences with Steve-O, me and him went and saw
Endgame
yeah. last weekend. So, Steve-O was sitting right there last weekend. And you weren't here. Could have had him.
Could
have had
him.
A threefer. Actually, we did some streaming afterwards, but... I never realized that the bar at the AMC in Mayfair
is really expensive.
It's well, yeah, everything there is really expensive, but it's named MacGuffin's.
Why?
You know what a MacGuffin is?
No.
A MacGuffin is a term for a plot device in a movie, like an infinity. I don't know if you've seen. You
like Infinity
seen
Stones.
Yeah, like Let's see.
Like Infinity Gauntlet.
It's a good MacGuffin. Like the briefcase in Pulp Fiction.
Gotcha.
That's a MacGuffin. Something that it's just a thing and it drives the plot. Or
yeah.
The ring in Lord of the Rings. It's a MacGuffin.
Gotcha.
So we were just standing in this fucking ridiculously long line to just get popcorn.
Anybody come dressed as Thanos?
No. Some motherfucker...
You see the guy
fully,
with the dog tail?
Fully dressed as Spider-Man.
That one's easy, though.
Yeah, yeah, it is, because you got a mask over your face. And
you just buy one of those Green Man onesies, basically.
Yeah.
Yeah.
You got a mask over your face, and nobody knows it's you, so you could just go full art-hard.
Yeah, that's what the Deadpool guys like, too. What was that, Halloween? God. That was Halloween, like, 4 years ago.
I'm Deadpool at a cosplay thing. I'm going to touch girls' butts and be like, oh, did I do that?
Aren't I a stinker? yeah, but that was, what, Halloween three or four years ago?
I made this comment to Steve-O, pointed him out. He's like, dude, there's a guy fully dressed as Spider-Man up there. This is, like, as people were waiting for, like, the post-credit roll, which it didn't have for once. No spoilers, okay? So Steve goes, this guy up there dressed like Spider-Man is like, I hope he doesn't have like a sawed-off shotgun and just like start shooting people.
Did he?
That's been that's been a hard-line rule since the fucking Batman...
Bane guy?
Was it the Dark Knight or was it...
Dark Knight Rises.
The Dark Knight Rises where the guy fucking shot up the movie theater.
I think it was Dark Knight Rises.
It's been like a pretty hard line rule and pretty understood. It's like you don't wear, even if it's like a costume night thing where people dress up, it's like you don't wear a face mask.
Yeah, well, the world's quick to forget and pretty lax.
Yeah.
So unless you're at the airport.
It was good, though.
Yeah, I heard from a couple guys at work it was pretty good.
Nowhere near as good. Well, I wouldn't say nowhere near. Not as good as Infinity War. it was good, but Infinity War was just like, I feel like it was like, mwah. It's a good movie.
Was that because Endgame was the end?
Well, it's not really the end. It made $1.3 billion at the box office.
I know,
office.
But I mean, it's the end of the arc, basically, right?
I mean, in that, yeah.
Is that what makes it, is that what made it worse than Infinity War, or was just
kind
Infinity
of
War
like,
just better overall?
I feel like Endgame was just more of a mess. There was like a bunch of plot lines going on, and there was substantially less characters in it, where Infinity War just fucking had everybody in it. And like there was consecutive storylines going on, and they made it not messy. Like, there was a lot of people involved with maybe like four different plot
lines. In Infinity War.
Yeah. And it wasn't messy. It was like well put together. And Thanos was an interesting character in that, so give it a watch.
We'll get to it.
Watch it.
I already saw the half in the bag thing. It's the first time I've ever seen a half in the bag thing.
Oh, really? You watched that before you actually watched the...
I don't know. I was on Reddit one day, and I was like, getting ready.
Half in the bag's great.
I think I was getting ready Sunday morning.
They put out a...
It was just funny, because they were like, it reminded me a lot of the last episode of Star Trek Voyager. And also, ironically, named Endgame. And like, that was really funny for me.
That's a running joke in those... Yeah. Where anytime Mike starts talking about Star Trek, fucking the other guy just goes fucking white-faced, and then they'll just be like, Mike talks about Star Trek for the next 5 minutes.
But the points he brought up for Endgame to Endgame were pretty funny for me.
They published a new Best of the Worst today. Those are my favorites. Where they just shit on, they pick like three different movies to shit on for an hour. Those are the best.
Well, I've pretty much canceled all my subscriptions except Amazon Prime because they have so many great shitty movies on there.
Oh, is that where you're gonna fucking invest in? They got a lot of bad stuff on there.
Oh yeah, it's great.
I mean,
I watched Deathstalker 1 and 2. The other ones have already been riffed by Riff Tracks and MST3K. They have actually almost all of Riff Tracks on there. They've got...
Really? They got Riff Tracks on there?
Yeah, for free. Good chunk of them. And one of them called Honor and Glory was just great. They had Hobgoblins,
Honor and Glory, what was that one about? That rings a bell. That's like ding.
It was like a female CIA agent and a female newscaster team up to get something called The Trigger. And they both know karate.
A MacGuffin.
Yeah, and they both... it's supposedly activates a nuclear device. And they team up to bring down some weird buff karate guy with a black boxing specialist who actually doesn't know boxing, knows karate too. It's just a really crappy 80s karate movie.
Yeah, yeah, and it's the one in the beginning where like some business karate guy ousts some guy out of his dojo, right? And then they move.
No.
No?
The beginning of this one, the government's like, we can't let news of this nuclear device be let out into the public. And then 2 seconds later, the CIA agent walks up to a newscaster and she's just like, I need your help getting this nuclear trigger out of villainous hands.
Let me get the snook out of my snus.
But they also have a lot of Westerns on there that I watched that were pretty bad and some pretty good ones. Watch Stagecoach with the actual Highwaymen supergroup. Not the John Wayne version. The one with Willie Nelson, Chris Christopherson, and Johnny Cash. That movie was terrible.
Honor and Glory.
Great guys, but they can't act for worth a damn.
FBI agent Tracy Pride.
Yeah, they all got really bad names, too. And then I just got told about another movie called Nuki, which is essentially a ripoff of Mac and Me, which was already a ripoff of E.T.
Oh my god, I told my dad to watch the Riff Track, or not Riff Tracks. How dare I?
The Mystery Science Theater rip on
Mac and Me.
Did he?
Today, like movie, literally though. Today.
Oh.
When I was talking to him in the morning. How many of those movies in that season were like just like ripoffs of other movies that were popular at the time?
A good chunk of them.
Was that the theme? Atlantic Rim?
I feel like overall, yeah.
I watched the other Pacific Rim.
I'm sure there were two.
Yeah.
Was it good or bad? I heard it.
Everybody says it's like super shit, but it's like, come on, it's robots punching sea monsters.
How mad can you be?
I do feel like a legitimate gripe about the second one is it's just a little bit more fast paced, and it's like a typical sequel. It does the same thing, but it doesn't have the same heart, because typically the director of the first one has done their thing, but then the studio's like, but wait, there's more. There has to be more. We made money. And then they hire some other director to come in who just doesn't get it.
Yeah.
And I feel it. But honestly, for like robots punching robots, that's still there.
Yeah.
And not robots. Well, actually, there is some robots punching robots in this one.
Punching giant monsters.
But actually, first there's some robots punching robots. And then there's some robots punching sea monsters. But it went more in the Transformers way of action, where it's like faster paced. Instead of just giant, slow, weighty punching stuff. Just like giant. Yeah, I want the weight. That, like, when huge robots fight, like, there's no mass. Like, the laws of physics don't exist. I don't like that.
I'm moving a fist really slowly at my other hand. Like that.
Yeah.
That's what you're looking for.
Maybe not that slow, but...
No, I get you. When you go to... watching Transformers where things are moving like a million miles an hour and Michael Bay is literally trying to give me a seizure.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Absolutely. There was some of that in Endgame, which led to me not liking it as much. But I felt like there was less of that in Infinity War.
Just got to take all your action sequence cues from Jackie Chan.
He'll teach you how to line it up.
Yeah, he'll teach you how to line it up. Yeah, I watched some not Pacific Rim, but I watched some giant monster movies. They have those on there too. Some terrible 80s, I think they're referred to as sexploitation, where it's just like hot chicks in the 80s running around doing action hero beat 'em up stuff. Like, I basically watched three versions of a female Mad Max movie. I think one was called like Phoenix Warrior, where there was only women on this sandblasted, nuclearly destroyed planet.
Female Zardoz?
Yeah, basically. Yeah, like I watched a couple movies like that. There was one that was in the same, that like Conan high fantasy theme, where there was two like twin sisters who one felt what the other one felt.
Was that a
and it was really awkward.
Oh,
and the movie
felt like the Coruscant brothers, that Cheech and Chong movie. Have you seen that movie?
No, I like Tamok and Zaymot from G.I. Joe. I haven't seen that Cheech and Chong movie.
It's like the same concept for a Cheech and Chong movie where they're like in the French Revolution. They're like born and separated at birth. And when one gets hurt, the other one feels it.
Yeah, that. I mean, this was supposed to be a serious movie, but it felt like it was written by a father who was unable to have the conversation about the birds and the bees with his son, because like they didn't even know they were women at like a point in the movie, and then like it just expands into complete ridiculousness. I think it was called
I see the folly of your ways now. You got this maximized. You don't got the chat up. There you go.
It's here.
There, you can see it now.
I'm looking for the flashes. There's no flashes. But yeah, Amazon Prime.
Are there flashes in the movies you were talking about just now?
Flashes on the screen to see if anything's happening. There is a lot of flashing in the 80s movies. But yeah, Amazon Prime is just full of terrible things. They have Road Warrior, aka Mad Max 2, on there.
That's not a terrible thing.
But the thing is there's a lot of...
That's the only good original Mad Max movie.
The thing with it is, though, is you have to buy or rent it.
Yeah,
there's a lot of crap on Amazon where it's like, we include all this. Oh, I like this movie. You click on it. Oh, I got to rent it or buy it. And it's like $13.
Have you seen The Road Warrior?
Not since I was a wee lad. I don't remember much about it.
That is the best one. I remember seeing Beyond Thunderdome. Was the first one
with Tina Turner?
Yeah, that one's just fucking weird. That one's fucking.
That
weird.
One's free.
Because nobody wants to watch that.
All the crap
one.
Stuff's free, so that I have a pretty. I like
they
it.
Got Master Blaster and the Feral Children that survived the Pucky Clips and.
I watched a
Junktown.
I watched a great crime noir though called Farewell to Love. It was exactly like one of those radio drama type Lou Pickles telling Tommy Pickles about...
She entered the door.
Yeah. And I watched the joke one with Patrick Warburton.
Tommy, you've been drinking again.
Yeah, exactly like that. And I watched the joke one with Tommy Warburton. Patrick Warburton and Andy Dick. I forgot what it's called.
What?
Hold on. Let me bring it up. I forgot the name of this movie. It was ridiculous. Patrick Warburton is an
ex-gay
porn star.
Andy Dick and Film Noir do not go together.
He's the leader of a Scientology cult. Well, it's called...
Speaking of Scientology, we'll revert back to that. Did you hear about the Scientology...
It's called Rock Slide.
Rock Slide?
And it's about an ex-gay porn star who goes to become a...
Andy Dick.
No, Patrick Warburton. He's Rock Slide. And he becomes a PI after his gay porn days. And another person who lives in his building, Andy Dick, is actually a cult leader who is trying to get him evicted from the building. It's pretty good.
So did you read that story I sent in?
About the Scientology's trapped on the measles boat?
Yeah.
I heard those cruise boats are just like work boats.
This is the boat is named the Free Winds. It's not even that big of a boat, to be honest. But it's the boat that the Scientologists go to reach like their last spiritual rung of the cult. It's supposed to be like
measles outbreak.
Yeah. Let's see. What do they call the actual last?
You think a group of people called the Scientologists would want to get vaccinated?
The cruise ship has a prime spot in Scientologist lore. To a Scientologist boarding the Free Winds for New Ot 8, the highest level in Scientology hierarchy.
How much money do you have to pay to take that one?
I don't fucking know.
What do you think they do on there? Just big sex orgies or what?
Apparently it's full of Tom Cruise dancing to old time rock and roll. Yeah, it says right here. It's the ship where Tom Cruise did the splits while singing a rendition of old time rock and roll on his 49th birthday.
So it's a go.
And where a woman says she was made to work for 12 years against her will.
That's the last story I heard about that. Yeah.
It also says a man says he ziplined off the ship using something like a rolling pin draped over one of the ship's cables connecting it to the port to escape being held captive against his will back in 1996.
Well, I imagine, yeah, the crew is all just enslaved Scientologists.
Yeah, so now they're
so
actually...
fucking Tom Cruise can just get his rocks off.
Maybe Tom Cruise he orchestrated the measles outbreak. So we could.
Do you think that?
No, I don't think that. I'm just trying to
stir up some controversy.
Yeah, just trying to stir up some conversation. But yeah, they have been stuck at port since Monday, Tuesday.
You should have thrown something crazy out there, like since 1996.
Some say they're still there to this day. How crazy is that, though, that measles is just, like, coming back with a vengeance because...
People are dumb. There's a guy at my work that doesn't believe in vaccines. He's dumb.
Wow, you should just go punch him. You should just go punch him in his mouth, man.
I'd love to. Yeah, but seriously, you'd think a group of people called the Scientologists would believe in some form of science.
You need to purge yourselves of these evil thetans, Stefan, and... Get right with
put your triangle hat on, bro. Open your third eye. Boy.
Oh man, that's like a whole nother sect of the same goddamn thing.
Same but different.
Yeah. Same but different. I should make a breakout of that video where Ryan describes his cult story. That was like a really unique story, and I never made it into a highlight. Just gonna show up one day, he's gonna be like, dude, what the fuck?
Cults.
How come all of a sudden, like, I remember us, like, he was like, do you feel comfortable talking about this? Well, he was like, I don't think they're going to come after me, hopefully.
And then they did. Isn't that one, like, completely closed down, though?
Yeah, at least, like, the large... Avatar something. It's like a Scientology.
Yo, come set. Get us. This is Guerrilla Radio. Speaking of cults, that made me think of mantras. And a long time ago, you sent me a video of a guy who repeats a mantra, and then he turns into the Green Goblin. I forgot.
Oh, bucket. William Dafoe.
Yeah.
By William Dafoe. By Will alone, I something like that.
My mind...
So, it's a from line Dune. From Dune, yeah.
Yeah, I
it's
was like, watching.
By will alone, my mind is set free. By will alone, my mind is set free.
Yeah.
By will alone, my mind is set free. By William Dafoe, my mind is set free. By William Dafoe. William Dafoe, my mind is set free.
Yeah. Well, I didn't catch that at first.
Ravioli.
Yeah, I didn't catch that at first, but I watched Dune the other day, and holy crap, that movie is terrible.
Yeah, it's the worst, dude. It is the worst.
It starts off like okay, and then you get about
and then Patrick Stewart is like, "I'm gonna fight you with polygons, laddie."
And then he gets a skullet.
The sleeper must awaken.
Yeah,
Arrakis, you control spice. Controls yours.
Yeah, it starts
and
out.
And then there's a gross worm guy fucking
flying around
in a fish tank, and then
and a fat guy who can fly.
And fucking Sting.
Yeah. Who the fat guy has like weird, clearly disingenuous intentions.
That movie is just terrible, yeah, dude.
But it starts out okay, and then you get like a third of the way in, and you're just like, this got off the rails extremely quickly.
The Bene Gesserits.
Yeah.
The Bene Gesserits are space nuns.
And you got Patrick Stewart running around with a skullet by the end of the movie. With fucking hair plugs and shit.
You got that one guy from fucking the Stallone Judge Dredd who fucking shoots himself as he's on the fucking Council of Judges. He's like the main character's father.
Oh, the Baron.
And people are just like, oh, it's a classic. It's like,
it's fucking awful.
Yeah, what? Like, they joke about that on the Peep Show. It's like, fucking Webb is trying to make up to Mitchell for, like, exposing him for, like, his fantasy porn collection. He's like, oh, I thought maybe, like, later we could hang out and watch Dune.
Yeah, it's terrible. At least the David Lynch one's pretty big disaster.
Oh, man, David Lynch is just... I recently...
It had some cool visuals, though.
Last week, I saw a thing that David Lynch was in that the guy who made Salad Fingers made. It's a promotional piece for Flying Lotus, the electronic artist. Are you familiar with Flying Lotus?
This is all over my head, except it's you like said a, Salad Fingers and Spoon Hands.
Flying David Lotus Lynch. Is a very prolific, I wouldn't say just like straight up electronica, like a looping artist, like sample-based loop music, breakbeat maybe.
He's a looper.
I think this is like an advertisement for like their new album. It's something called Fire Is Coming, and... The video was directed by the guy who made Salad Fingers, so you can kind of get an idea of, like, the creepy aesthetic of what it is. It's just, like, a bunch of children in fucking, like, it's almost like, fucking wolf hoodies, and they're just fucking just going crazy in this apartment.
Children of the Wolf.
And this fucking, like... stuffed animal wolf figure in a wheelchair comes through the door and it opens its mouth and it's like and fucking David Lynch's head comes out of its mouth and he's just like explaining this stupid story. He's like, the phone was ringing and David made his way
I gotta watch this after this. That sounds great. How long is it? Like a minute and a half?
A couple minutes.
Okay.
Yeah, it's not like a very big investment in time, but it's like...
Because Dune was like 3 hours.
Yeah.
And it was fucking terrible.
Yeah, skip Dune. Go watch Fire Is Coming.
Yeah, Dune was fucking terrible.
Didn't David Lynch direct Twin Peaks?
I don't know.
That's like a
Twin Peaks is beloved, but Brittany watched it not that long ago, and I was just like, I can't get into this. This is not for me.
I think a lot of the people who talk about it nowadays talk about it through like nostalgia glasses because it was one of the first like high art concepts to just be like, oh, this is on Fox.
Yeah, it's definitely a surreal psychological thriller.
Yeah. But that was like one of the first things in the 90s, like putting something on TV.
And you get to watch
like
Mulder cross-dress.
Fucking David Duchovny.
Yeah, he thinks he's a woman for a good chunk of that.
No, they just put Evolution on Netflix, man. You seen that one?
No.
Oh, dude, watch that, dude. It's the spiritual successor to Ghostbusters. If there was a Ghostbusters 3 that didn't suck because 2 sucked, and that's what has that, like, sequels only get worse sometimes.
You talking about the newest Ghostbusters 2? Because Ghostbusters with...
No, I'm talking about Ghostbusters 2, the first one.
With I think that the was Baron? Like 89. Who comes out of the painting?
Yeah.
That wasn't as bad.
I mean, but it wasn't...
It wasn't fucking dynamite, but it wasn't that bad.
But Evolution is an Ivan Reitman flick.
Oh, gotcha.
So it has the spirit of Ghostbusters. Ivan Reitman did Empire Strikes Back, too, didn't he? Pretty sure he was.
You're asking the wrong guy these kind of questions. I just watch the films and go, oh, terrible. Yeah.
Oh, it was okay. It was pretty good.
Like, if you want to watch
something. Sucks.
Yeah.
It was terrible. Boo.
Yeah, if you want to watch something really terrible, watch the movie Hobgoblins
2. Hobgoblins 2.
I think I only watched the first one.
Yeah, Evolution. It has David Duchovny. Orlando Jones, not Bloom.
The new Sonic trailer. Did you guys see the new Sonic trailer in chat?
Oh, God. Yes. Who asked like that?
Pewter Odin.
Who the fuck is that?
The new Sonic trailer, though?
The new Sonic trailer, I was like, what the fuck is this? And then Jim Carrey walks up, and I was like...
Why is he in this?
Is it really? I wonder if it's one of those movies that is actually good and they just managed to make it look terrible. Case in point, Home Alone 3. If you look at trailers for that movie, it looks fucking awful. It's like, what the fuck is this? And you watch it, it's like, oh, that was actually kind of along the lines of like 1 and 2 and 3. But then 4.
I don't know.
And then there was 5.
First of all, I'm just going to say what everybody's thinking. Sonic looked fucking weird.
He looked like a fucking dude with a beer belly in a fur suit.
Yeah.
It was just like, man, I smoked too many cigarettes.
I guess they're going to redesign him, though. I read that today. Like,
I read
right
that,
before
too.
I got here.
And everybody, I saw some people online, which was just like, you're going a little bit too far. They were just like, oh, all you people are protesting. Like, if you do it, things get done. And it was, like, in regards to, like, the Sonic redesign. And I was like, okay, really? Far more things look wrong with that movie
than just Sonic. Oh, it's Steve-O.
Oh, yeah, he fucking said... I told Steve-O when we walked out of the fucking theater, or we were going, I was like, you see any of that's like, Sonic promotional shit? And then when we walked out, there was a... Off in the corner, there was a Sonic that was like, Steve-O. Over there.
But do you really think Jim Carrey I just remember reading some comments and they're like, Jim Carrey is gonna save this. It's like, are you delusional? If it's gonna bomb, probably.
I mean, what's he been in recently?
Nothing. He's been painting pictures.
Yep. I mean, gotta be run out of money somehow if you someday if you spend way too much on a mansion.
Yeah, I don't know about a Sonic movie. The world's just not ready. I'm not ready.
It's just not necessary. Okay. What other side-scrolling games had movies? Super Mario Brothers. widely hailed as one of the worst video movies ever. Yeah, not
Google
just
a
video
picture of a Goomba, please, from that movie.
Do it. I'm not hooked up to it. A Goomba from fucking Mario
like
Brothers,
fucking dinosaur.
The live action movie starring Don Hodgkins and fucking John Leguizamo.
I love you, John.
I do love John Leguizamo, but look at that! Look at the fucking Goomba!
With the little, like, Nazi lapel.
And they talked like this. They were like, hey! Hey!
here's a full-size image of one of them.
That's Toad, actually. Toad gets turned into a Goomba, and they give him a fucking, they give him a harmonica to play. So imagine... Is that the actor?
No, that's fucking Tom Brady on the bench.
Oh, Jesus. Now, the thing is, man, I enjoyed that movie as a kid. You know why? Because I was an idiot.
I could just see. I love Mario. Oh, you dummy. Oh, man.
There was stories from that movie being so awful that the cast knew it was going to be awful. Because it
just
basically...
John Leguizamo just smoking back stogies and chugging full bottles of Jim Beam.
It became this hodgepodge of what the original director intended it to be, which was some sort of like dark spin on the Super Mario universe.
I'm going to be the next Tim Burton.
But mind you, this is before like the Dark Knight and like all the Nolan shit, where they took like the superhero stuff into like the dark thing.
We're gonna put them in a gritty universe and show you the dirt.
This was Nintendo's first movie deal.
Are we gonna have a view party of this at some point? Because this is like the third time we brought it up.
We gotta. Well, just could. Do you think
we're gonna invite one of our viewers right now to come to the view party?
I'm gonna fucking
Pewter Odin. Can you make it to a view party?
We'll just all sit down, stream it, and just talk shit about this terrible, terrible movie. But apparently, it was supposed to be dark and gritty, which matches the fucking like post-apocalypse fucking movie setting that this is in. That Mario the game does not take place in.
One plumber.
There was two plumbers.
A plumber and his brother, who's also a plumber,
fighting in an inferno, and then aliens. It's called Two Brothers.
It's called Super Brothers, Mario.
The original director was supposed to make this gritty flick, and then Nintendo was just like, "Nah, this is a children's game." I can just imagine.
No, Nintendo probably finally got to like view a snippet of it, and they're just like, "This is awful. What are you doing?
We can't do this with the IP."
And these are children.
They just shit canned it, and they were still like filming it, I believe, when they switched it, and the actors were just like, "This is terrible. It was bad before, but this is really bad." So then, just to like get through shooting all like the ridiculous shit that they had, they just started like day drinking.
Oh yeah, I believe it. And it was the early 90s, right?
Oh, yeah. Then, like, what a... another movie. Street Fighter. That one was really bad. I have not seen that one since I was a kid.
Yeah, I haven't
but
seen
even
it. That's
as
on Amazon, though. I was thinking about watching it.
We should sit down and watch it together sometime. That one, even as a kid, I was like, this is bullshit. Like, literally, like... 7-year-old me was like, this fucking
All right, what'd you
sucks.
Think of the Mortal Kombat movie, though?
I loved it.
Yeah, everybody loved
oh,
it.
Oh, fucking ate it up. Guess. Fucking, they got McCloud in there.
Speaking of which, did I ever share with you that really weird Mortal Kombat really soundtrack weird. I got that wasn't for the game or the movie? It was like a rap. I'll find it for you before I leave. But,
Oh, please don't.
Oh, yeah. You're going to love it. But are you entertaining getting the new Mortal Kombat?
11? I mean, I'm not really, like, a fighting game guy. I mean, maybe if I had more friends, that actually came over, and it was like a like one of those games. Yeah, do that. But like, I got this guy on my Facebook feed who talks about Injustice 2, the fucking DC
versus Mortal Kombat one.
I don't think it's
that's just the versus, DC fighting game.
It's DC fighting game.
It's in the Mortal Kombat system, though, I think.
Oh, that's what you meant by it. Just like always makes Facebook posts about this game. Nobody ever says anything back to him. Apparently, he's like really into like the competitive scene about this.
Maybe he just likes it. Well, those games have smaller competitive like, scenes too.
Is always nobody ever says anything to him ever on Facebook.
Sometimes it doesn't like, matter for some people.
I was like, this poor guy.
Just keep on trucking. That's my message for him. Keep trucking, man. Drive yourself right off that cliff, buddy. So should I share the story that I texted you about that chick, that goalie?
I don't remember this.
Okay, that'd so be yeah. Great. Okay, so tell. So
I was vaguely remember.
Yeah, it was one of the pickup hockey games.
So Stefan could not make last weekend. There was no show last weekend.
Yeah, I had the pickup hockey game. That's actually when this happened.
So this was Friday.
Yeah. So I go to this pickup hockey game, and you know, I get there a little early. Starts filling up, and the two goalies show up, and the goalies play for free. And I've played with both of them before.
Fucking Hans and Franz.
Yeah, I've played with both of them before, and one of them is this smaller girl, and I'm just, you know, we take the ice. They're both talking to each other. I'm just like, all right, this should be a decent game. Like, I know the one guy's pretty good. I don't really know how this chick is as a goaltender too well. I just remember she kind of slacks on the rebounds or whatever. But we get out there, she must have let up like 30 goals. Like, I scored. You know what I mean? This guy and I felt like shit that
Who's
game.
Who's the too. Goalie from Mighty Ducks?
Goldberg.
Goldberg, they just fucking taper.
And I felt taper like to shit the goal. Too. Because it was actually Saturday. It was a Saturday game because we drank the night before. Mm-hmm.
After your glorious victory.
And yeah, I drank here with you the night before. It was two weekends ago because I played that Saturday. That was the night I came over here. We had a couple little bit of wine and spritzer going on over here.
Did not drink that much.
No, but after that, I went to Stevens and I drank like half a bottle of vodka because they just drink vodka Stefan. Over there.
Jesus.
Yeah, hammering them back. But I had Pepto on the bench. Like, I felt like shit, and I scored on this. Yeah, I felt like shit. I had Pepto on the bench. I had a bottle of water. I, like, was doing everything I could not to toss up my lunch on the ice. And I even scored on this chick. But this one guy would just go backhand on her every time he scored on her, like, seven times. It was just a shit show, like an absolute gong show. Like, this chick was getting scored on left or right. At the end of the first, it was 13 to, like, 2. And then they switched who was playing goalie for who because it's just pickup. We come back. It's 13 to, like, 14. And then we switch back, and then she lets in a couple more, and we ended up losing. But we get back in the locker room, and I'm just like, I'm just glad to be off the ice with my Pepto. I'm just like, I'm glad that's over. I'm just going to hydrate. I'm going to go home, just take a shower. Just
don't touch my fucking Percocets.
Yeah, I'm just going to be done with this bullshit. But we're in the locker room. And I just hear this. They're like passing out a couple beers, and somebody has Yulin, and I hear, "Oh, Yulin, I love Yulin. You know, I'm going to Philly next week to play with." Sorry, that's my impersonation. I'm going to Philly next week to play with the Croatian Olympic team, and I'm just like, you know, like my head is just like, what? Like, is that? That's like a really bold claim because it's only a Google search away to see who's on the Croatian Olympic team. She's like, yeah, we're going to be playing the Lebanese Olympic team. And like, I'm sitting here, I'm just thinking to myself, you let up like 30 goals in a men's pickup league game. If you're going to be playing with the Olympics, I'm going to be going pro by the end of the year. Like, I don't, hey, maybe I'm wrong. and maybe she is gonna be, but it's just like such a bold claim, and it just
that sounds like the one time an ex-roommate of mine had a girlfriend of his come over, and before she came over, he showed us this version of Hallelujah that he
this is such a great story.
He he believed it. She told him that she had sang this version of Hallelujah, and we were like, oh wow, that's really, like, really good. And like, he had a copy of it, so we're just like chilling out in the fucking living room playing Modern Warfare 2. That's how old this story is now. And just hear them fucking just railing this chick. She comes back out. She was like an ex-army chick. And we were just like playing Call of Duty, by the way. She's like, man, like, I love this shit, but just give me flashbacks. We're like, ew. So they go back for a second round, and we get on YouTube, and we find the fucking version of Hallelujah that this chick claimed that she had sung. And we were just like, that's the exact same version. So we go get the copy of the song that my ex-roommate, I don't want to say his name by name, had provided us, and we're like, it's the same fucking song. She lied to him.
Yeah, she tried to pull the fast
fucking
one.
Lied to him. So we call him, like, he comes out from the sex, and we're like, Sean, come here.
Bro, yeah, you got
you have to
right
check this out.
Now.
And he's just like, no, she did that. I was like, no, dude. Like,
oh, I got news for you.
She was lying to you. So the fucking guy is just, he fucking goes in the room and is just like, put your fucking clothes on and get the fuck out of here. He literally like fucking throws her out of the house after they just got done boning. Did you imagine that? You just came. You
what a
fucking
great walk of shame,
walk
though.
Out to get some fucking water, and your roommates are just like, hey, check this out. This bitch was lying to you. And you go through your fucking, your denial phase to your realization phase.
To acceptance.
To acceptance. And then you go just toss the bitch out of the fucking, you just grab her by the neck and throw her out in the hallway.
God, what a, was it the lady from the, that YouTube pop sensation that you've shared with me? I forgot her name. Mrs. Voice.
Oh man, we should just like start hyping those up during the episodes and then,
and then drop
those.
Them.
Yeah. We got to revisit those. Cause we have two, I think, time coded in the chamber, ready to work on.
I gotta get some free time.
We got to get some other content. Like those, I feel like those are better formatted for us because you could just work on them whenever you want.
Yeah.
But like any job where it's you're your own boss, you have to drive yourself to do it.
Yeah, I got to get time.
That's the pitfall.
I'll make some time.
It's not that you got to get time. Like you said, you got to
make
time.
Make time. What time is it? Game time.
I watched the Mighty Ducks. And the first time in my adult life. It's actually not that bad a movie. It's kind of heartwarming.
Buddy, I found this album.
The Immortals?
It's called Mortal Kombat, the album.
Yeah, it was like the best thing ever with the fucking techno song on
this
it.
This is something different. This is what, because my brother asked for the Mortal Kombat album. Because the movie had dropped. Was one of the... Okay, back in the day, before you guys downloaded everything, just like your movies, there used to be people who would make rip-off albums, just like Atlantic Rim. And this was one of them.
So was this pre... You said it was pre-download?
This was Bargain Bin. Yeah, this was... You had... This is when there was only CDs. Napster didn't even exist yet.
Okay.
And my parents got my brother this album, and my brother was just like, this is not it. And he gave it to me. But I spent some time listening to this terrible album, and I'm going to share it with you.
All right, you got an excerpt for it? You got a. Oh, I thought you already had this prepped.
You're no, like, I'm going to share it. I with just you. Finally found it.
So, are you sure that this is?
Prepare yourself.
This is it.
This is the opening song, dude.
Oh! 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 Oh!
Yeah.
Oh!
Zombie! Zombie Nation!
This is totally some Euro trash shock soccer hooligan bullshit.
Oh, it totally is. Yeah.
Oh man.
But I mean, you imagine my brother's surprise?
Me 10 years ago, I would have ate this shit up.
But can you imagine my brother's surprise when he thought he was getting the actual movie soundtrack and he got this fucking shit? Oh my god. There's some gems on here.
I mean, I could see how they would be like, yeah, we could sell this. Oh my god, techno in the 90s is a fucking lawless waste. Mortal Kombat!
Dun, dun, oh my dun, god, dun, dude. Dun, dun, dun. Should I just keep it going?
Stop it.
We'll come back to
stop
that later.
It. We gotta find another video we can do in threes, like the fucking, was it not Summer Sanders, but Ed Summers and fucking Burt Reynolds fucking pie fighting each other on Leno. If you remember that.
Yeah, I know. I remember that. What do you mean do them in threes?
We did that in threes. We like kind of almost watched that entire video. We like had segments.
Oh, yeah.
Where like we came back to it at like different points in the episode. Just chew that cud.
This is the guy behind the genius of it.
Who the fuck is that? Ugh. Is that like Britney Spears' mom?
Praga Khan.
Praga Khan. Man, I hope he... I bet he made a bunch of movies. Money. Bunch of money. Because... Okay, take it. Pacific Rim and Atlantic Rim. I feel like your margins on that one, depending on how cheap you can make the movie... Are going to be very low
very
because
good.
people are going to figure it out pretty quickly that that's not the right one. But this was something that was in Walmart pre-internet.
Yeah. This is like a Best Buy
along with a fucking like Blockbuster.
And like this was the actual album cover. That's what the album cover looked like. Mortal Kombat, the album.
Like, how did they get away with that?
It was a lawless waste, like you said.
Yeah. I mean, God, if I could just go back in time to the 90s, I wouldn't even tell myself, you know, do this, do that, young me. I'd just go commit copyright fraud and
just eat it up.
Make a bunch of money. Oh, that was back in the day where you could get bootleg, like Chinese bootleg video games, like 100 on a CD ROM. Not your standard CD. CD-ROM of just, like, Chinese bootleg video games. There was, like, this really bad Pac-Man collection. It was, like, the Pac-Man collection, and it was, like, 3D Pac-Man. But it was, like, okay.
Q-Bert.
Somebody in China had looked at, like, Crash Bandicoot. And decided to be like, I'll just do that, but with, I'll call it Pac-Man. And it was like it was like the hokiest, cheapest 3D Pac-Man that you could. It was like super buggy. And it was like a fucking child drew it almost. But there was a series of like, I don't know, 7 games. But it was like in fucking Walmart.
What is going to happen to all those people?
What?
The bargain bin warriors, like the Atlantic Rim creators and Square Man.
Oh, now that it's going to just...
Downloads?
Yeah. I don't know. I don't really understand, like, the money making mechanic of that when it comes to like independence. Because with studios, you know, with like Fox, one that not even Fox anymore, like Disney, and who else is there now? Who doesn't Disney own?
Disney and Sony.
Okay, yeah, Sony's another one. Warner Universal.
Brothers? Is Warner Brothers separate?
Yeah, Warner Brothers is separate, I'm pretty sure. Pretty sure Universal's still out there. Like, those big deals to, like, stream content. Like, I understand where the money comes from with that. Like, that drives in subscriptions. That's how they make the money. But for, like, these smaller companies, where it's like you're a small independent company and you get your shit on Netflix, where does the money come from? Like, Spotify at least has, I don't know, you can make a certain amount off of a certain amount of plays, period.
But I don't know how Spotify's payment system works. You get like a cent or something for each listen, don't you?
Not even. It's like a fraction of a cent. It's like such a low amount that, like, just to make minimum wage on Spotify plays, you have to have a ridiculous amount of plays. So it's really more about the, like, lucrative deals to, like, bring people to the platform for, like, more popular artists.
I know that, but, yeah, I guess I don't know much about Spotify. Oh, man.
You know what I do know about Spotify?
Is that we're on it.
I fucking...
Just kidding, we're not.
Got rid of it. Oh, yeah, I suppose. I have a battle plan for that. Once we get to episodes, like, where we get to episodes where 1 year ago we stopped playing the music, I'm going to keep those on YouTube and then just get them out of our RSS feed. So if you want to listen to the first 20 or so episodes, which just happens to be the episodes with Sean on them.
Yeah.
R.I.P.
I do miss the music.
Like, as just like ambiance. And to be honest, one of the things that frustrated me so much and just like probably drove a pillar between us more than anything was that I went and found, like, with like 2 days of research, I went and found a bunch of music just from people that were just like, yeah, you could use our music. Or just people putting themselves out there through, like, you want to use this in your thing, like, you want to use it in your podcast, whatever. It's like, was not that hard. So that's why I kind of just like doubled down and was just like, yeah, you just didn't even do that.
I think that was supposed to be me, though. I don't remember.
No, it was...
What is up with...
Just lick it. Yeah, just licking your asshole.
Just pleasuring itself.
If he could talk, there's no pleasure in it. Can you imagine being able to itch your own asshole with your sandpaper tongue?
No, because I don't think that's how I'd utilize it. But that's because I don't have the ability, so. Oh, man. Your dog is something else. Your cat is something else over here.
So you'd obviously saw this Xbox Live Community Standards update thing.
Oh, the what you can say on Xbox?
So, what's your feeling on that? God. I have mixed feelings about it.
So
for the people who don't know about it, Xbox and Microsoft is updating their community guidelines, and I think it's more their terms of use, that you can't be a fucking shitheel on Xbox Live.
They have recommended us Smack Talk.
Well, the first thing of it is they've put in place rules.
It's nice, like, potato aim.
You can't say certain things without getting banned, and there's consequences now. If you say, like, certain shit and you flame war people, like, we're talking, like, racist things. We're talking about, like, hate speech, I think, more so.
I don't
That's,
know.
Like, super... It's super rampant on the platform, I feel. Well, I don't feel it's... What do you mean you don't know? Have you ever fucking been called a FGGTNGGR by a 13-year-old on Xbox?
Oh, yeah.
Yeah. Like,
I played Halo back in the day.
That's kind of not cool. You know what I mean? It's been brought up, like, time and time again that this current... I don't want to be that person. But, like, the current generation wouldn't survive a day on Xbox fucking Live back when it first came out. It is...
No, just, definitely it wouldn't.
Is a terrible, toxic place. Like, our memories of it are just, like... It's just people saying terrible things.
I was forged by fire, okay? I can handle it, so yeah. I don't...
yes, you came to the doctor's house, I was born in it.
Yeah, I honestly, when I was last on Xbox, it was not nowhere near as bad as when I was younger. So I don't know if it ramped back up from the last. I mean, I haven't had an Xbox since 360.
Have you seen a what do they call it?
But I played League of Legends. That game's pretty terrible.
Well, that's just typing. That's just typing.
Yeah.
This is like people screaming it in your fucking ear, like doxing people.
What was the... Oh, I played... I have been known to play Rainbow Six Siege.
On Xbox? PC, yeah.
There's all kinds of ridiculous stuff on there.
I got Reed on there for like one of my first times ever just playing with
you. And yeah, you were like, I've never experienced this before.
Yeah. I just had a laugh at it because it was already a thing I had seen being parodied.
Yeah.
And I was like, oh, this is like a real one.
Yeah. But they're real. They're out there.
But so basically, Xbox, in order to combat what a perceived shithole their live community has become, like, that's how it's perceived everywhere. It's like you say Xbox Live, you don't like think about, oh, it's like a nice place to hang out. It's like a place to get called terrible things.
That's just online
by somebody who
is
nine.
That's just online games with chat.
I mean, not really. Most of my online experiences on PC,
fairly tame,
fairly pleasant. And I think that's mainly because who's playing games on PCs? Adults. For the most part. Sometimes you get some squeakers. It's not all the same.
I mean, the VR, though, that was a complete shock to me when we were on the VR.
I mean,
I was like, I can't believe your parents bought you this thing. It's pretty fucking expensive. That was my initial reaction.
We played this game called, it's one of the better VR games called Echo Arena. And it's almost like an Ender's Game thing where you're just in zero gravity. And
this is Disc Wars and Tron.
Yeah, there's not that one.
Hybridized with Aztec.
That one's straight up Ender's Game, the like game where they have to like go through like the cubes and zero G. It's like zero G football, and the field is 3D and it's all around you, and you have like obstacles and you have end zones, and there was he couldn't have been more than 8 year old kid, just being an annoying 8 year old kid. And it's terrible playing with the kids like that because they just don't know or care that they're just like everybody else is an adult, and they're just like blub 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 blub, I'm 8, and all the adults just like, shut the fuck up, kid. Shut up, you squeaker. Be quiet. And they're just like, hey, you guys, you need to
I'm
do
chicken tenders for dinner. Yeah.
And I mean, shame on us for that kind of thing. But on the inverse,
I
mean,
I didn't. I wasn't late. Well,
were you not?
Pass.
There's literally
the fifth. Yeah.
There's literally been on the Oculus Rift subreddit. There's a game called Rec Room, and it's basically like a chat room.
Go in there, play squash with the boys.
So you go in it, and it's like a VR chat thing, and it's just a lobby where you can like just talk to people. But there's also like arcade machines, so you can in a 3D VR space, you can walk up and go and play a 2D arcade machine of just like classic games, and then just like talk to people, and people were just like, for the love of God, parents, don't let your kids play this game. It's not because they're going to get exposed to adults. It's because they're so very, very annoying, and they're ruining it for it. This is just a nice place for adults to play retro games.
To remember the 80s, yeah.
So back to this. They are saying that they'll like suspend your account, but if you're a repeat offender, they'll literally go to the point where they will, on your Xbox Live account, they will revoke the licenses for games you've bought. They will take back the funds. They'll reduce your funds that you have in the Xbox fund money, like in your
account,
to zero.
Don't say the bad list. Don't say the bad words, or we'll strike you down. Basically, yeah.
But like, I feel like it's like, it's not like don't say the bad word. It's like shit you really shouldn't be saying to people. It's like chastising gay people, who are just like a targeted group. It's like
my problem is, I don't understand necessarily the brevity of how closely, or sorry, I don't know how exactly they're going about looking at it. Like if some guy just gets 50 ports piled on him by, I don't know, X group on Call of Duty, and they just take his account down, like, how, what's your review process on this and stuff like that?
They're going to have review processes, and I think it's more based on like machine learning and speech recognition than it is reports. Cause that's like a different thing now. Like in like a Blizzard game, you could just get like 50 reports and get banned, or a Riot. That used to be a thing. I haven't had that recently because I've played a few rounds of League of Legends lately, and you could literally get a fucking like strike on your account just for not being in the correct lane. And I was like, fuck this game. That's like one of the things that turned me off to it. It was like, okay, we got some meta piss babies that are angry that the game wasn't able, at this low level fucking play, wasn't able to mirror a pro match in their meta that wouldn't work anyways because they're not pros, just fucking reporting me for being in the wrong character, wrong lane. That's ridiculous.
I just don't like League of Legends. It's a poop game.
It's the principles, Stefan. It's the principles. But in this, I feel like you, like, okay, you're in your home. You're part of, like, a certain group that society kind of comes after. It's, like, hard to be a part of this group out in society, whichever one it may be.
You whether mean, you're being a gamer or being a neckbeard.
Whether you're black or like gay or trans, like you get this shit from society that us as like white guys don't really get, and then you just want to fucking be in the privacy of your own home, play your goddamn video game, be anonymous online. Part of like being anonymous online is that people think there are no consequences and they'll just fucking say terrible things. So as part of like that's why I don't like to like have us say like retard, something like that. It's like, okay, like we're just hitting on these people who are getting hit on like every day of their fucking lives. And this is supposed to be like a, these are games. It's supposed to be like a fun competitive space. Like, I kind of agree with it in that space.
I'd just be more concerned about what their actual review system is. So it's not like,
I'm sure
it's not like League of Legends where you just get the whole other team just decides to report you. And then guess what? You just got striked out.
Ooh, you got a lever buster. You can't play for
30 minutes or whatever the fuck that was.
Yeah, I see that other end of it. I see it as like a cash grab too.
People shouldn't be, people need to learn on developing their ability to chirp other people in games. That's definitely true. Instead of just leaning on really lame,
instead of like PewDiePie in them.
Yeah, they need to work on their chirp game and not just be leaning on, I don't even like the quotation most offensive words I can think of. Mm-hmm. You, like, you need to develop your chirp game more than just calling people whatever first jumps into your mind.
So let's jump to the absolute opposite end of the spectrum of this. Now that we've had the serious conversation, Microsoft is suggesting things to say in face of it, and it is just, it is some hello fellow kids shit.
Yeah, this is the, like, looking at that stuff, I was like, this is so cringy.
Let's see, what they're suggesting, that was some serious potato aim, get wrecked. I mean, get wrecked is like...
Hi, I'm an Overwatch character.
Get destroyed. Can't believe you thought you were on my level. That was some serious potato aim. Get wrecked. Only reason you went positive was you spent all game camping. Try again, kid. Cheap win. Come at me when you can actually drive without running cars off the road. That sucked. Good. And then come back when your KD's over one.
I mean, why don't you just say nothing personal, kid?
Nothing personal, kid, but you're fucking done. You're done, kid. You're out of here. You're never working this town again.
Well, that's the thing. I feel like eventually there'll be like no swear words on
okay, that's too far.
Yeah, no, but what if it was just like no swear words on not M-rated games or something online?
One of the things that made me go to voice recognition for them, like using that as a metric, is because there's a fucking, there's an NBA Live game that came out where if you swear because the Xbox can hear you, you get technical fouls. Like, if you swear at the game, they'll give you a technical
foul. That's so stupid.
I mean, I thought it was kind of funny.
It's funny, but it's really stupid.
If you could turn it off, I would be all for it.
But, yeah, it's just stupid.
I would just think like, at first, you get a technical foul because you swore, and you're like, oh, that's funny. I'm going to turn that off. And they let you? That would be like, okay, that's cool. That's pretty clever.
Like, I get it. You don't want to be, like, here's the thing. Maybe there are people out there that are saying derogatory things to people online, but at the same time, most games you have the option to turn off your voice chat. And then,
yeah, that is a thing too.
At another point, it's just like,
turn it off.
Are you like, it's like, how hard are you going to turtle at a point? Like, people shouldn't be saying certain things online, but at the same time, you probably shouldn't just be turtling and just like, I need Microsoft to make people stop saying things I don't want to hear.
I don't really think that's probably what happened. Like, people who belong to these chastised communities have thick skin. Like, not everybody in those communities are completely just
I'm not fragile. Even saying just the people in those communities. I'm talking more to the level of, you can turn off voice chat. You can, mm-hmm. like, I'm sure it's not just going to be the derogatory things that Microsoft's going to be coming after. It's going to be like NBA 2K where it's like, oh, you said fuck, here's a 2-minute minor there, buddy. You're sitting out for 15 minutes, you know, like.
I think it's maybe more of a result of like, okay, yeah, it's actually gotten this bad now. We should probably do something. Like, we can have nice things until you fuck it up, and then we have to have rules. And it's like, okay, you shitheels, you've done it long enough. Like, I mean, Xbox Live has been a thing since the early 2000s, and it's taken this long for them to fucking.
It was a lawless waste back then.
Yeah.
As you'd lovingly put it.
Like, fucking purple French's easy squirt ketchup, lawless waste.
And, yeah, like, I don't. There's definitely some people that have really bad chirp games, and, like, and people definitely do say things that are completely unnecessary to be having been said. But my big question is like, well, it more comes down to what exactly are they going to be banning? Like, are they, you know, is it going to end up with the, oops, I said, I didn't even say it. My older brother said fuck in the room over and basically turned on my Alexa, you know, a situation like that. And then I just got doxxed 10 points or whatever. You know what I mean? Like,
well, you get some strikes, but
it just makes me think about where's the line in the sand going to be drawn before.
Yeah, I feel like there's also like the potential for Microsoft to basically take people's money.
Yeah.
Because part of the rules is you lose licenses associated with the account. They're just going to like take the games that you've bought with that account.
Yeah, that's the other thing that's crazy about that. It's like, oh, Lil Timmy is an idiot and just flushed, I don't know, how much is a video game now? It's not $60 anymore. It's like $70 for a game.
Depends.
For an Xbox game,
though? I feel like $60 is the standard, and the special DLCs? Edition. The special edition is $70, where you get a special cloak and a pistol.
All right, let's say Timmy Roberts is buying Battlefield 3 with all DLC. How many games come out a year like that? Maybe one every 3 months where you got to pay like $150 for everything?
I don't think that much.
4 months? I don't know. Timmy buys four of those in
What's
1 year.
What's your point?
Little Timmy buys four, or his parents buy that four of those for him in a year. That's $150 a pop. Mm-hmm. So that's $600 plus the Xbox One. They're on Xbox One now these days, right? Look how old I am. How much is that? $450? $600?
Maybe.
Little Timmy got Xbox for his birthday, and 1 year later, just flushed it all $1,200 down the toilet because he's an idiot and didn't. He's just an idiot.
Well,
Microsoft just came.
Maybe it'll teach him to not be such a little cunt for the rest of his life.
Or daddy puts his head in the toilet.
I mean, yeah.
I guess it to me, it's more like, what's the framework for your determination of wrongdoing? What is your full list of repercussions? They obviously have tiers where it's like tier one, you're banned for, you're grounded for a week. Tier two, you're grounded for a month. Tier three, we're taking everything from you and bending you over.
Here's what it says directly from the article. It says, for breaking the rules, players can expect consequences, but Microsoft is hesitant to call it punishment. Quote, we are not out to punish, but rather to protect everyone's experience. End quote. For every corrective action, which the standards state could be a suspension or a restriction on the ability to send messages or stream live, Microsoft wants its players to learn from their mistakes. Players will be welcomed back to the community to prove that they've changed their ways, the company says. But that doesn't mean every abusive gamer will be welcomed back into the fold. Repeat offenders or particularly severe abuse will garner a punishment a permanent suspension, the standard state, which requires the profile owner to, quote, forfeit all license for games and other content, gold membership time, and Microsoft account balances, end quote. I mean...
And what if Slayer XI56 just has a vendetta against you, tags you on his little post-it notes and Googles you every time you come back and throws a report your way? I mean, obviously Microsoft's going to have to report him, but... I mean, people do that
shit. I mean, yeah.
People did that shit in World of Warcraft on Blizzard games all the time.
That's a little fucking weird.
Yeah, but people did that shit in World of Warcraft. They'd be like, oh, he's back. I'm going to go hit him with a report.
That's like probably like, I'm going to...
That's just as... That's vindictive.
Yeah, it's vindictive. Yeah. And it's like, this dude might fucking have issues.
Yeah.
If you are that problem.
I know, but I fear like abuse of the system. I don't know what the guidelines are for... I more fear abuse of the system and their, like the intention of the system is good. I fear abuse of the system. I fear, like, I'm hesitant.
I don't know what they're basing it on.
Yeah.
If they're basing it on speech recognition, I feel like that is safer than reports.
Because there's no way in hell they're going to have the boys up at NASA, you know, looking in every single Xbox Live chat report and reviewing it. So, at the not NASA, the NSA.
But voice recognition has come a long way.
I'm sure it has.
And honestly, how much power do you, as somebody who hates another player because you're salty, have to make them say something or make it seem like they've said something?
I agree with you.
That's pretty hard to do.
I agree with you. It's just the future, you know. It's these are the
future
days of
shock.
These are the days of our lives.
As the world turns, it's 1:41 in. Dougie's gotta pee.
Should I play us off with Sub-Zero from the Immortals? Yes. All right, here we go.
Oh, it's so terrible.
Just wait till you hear the dialogue on this one.